This is the standard way that Beat Saber's played. But what if someone lacked the fine motor skills to use or to even hold on to these controllers?
Hey, Dan, can I try? Thankfully, there's a company that thought of this and found a solution for disabled gamers like myself. The software they created allows my own arms to become the controller. Check this out.
What's going on, All Access Lifers, and welcome back to our channel, where Brad and I are living the All Access Life.
Today, we will be showing you how to make virtual reality accessible for people with disabilities. We were extremely excited when we got our hands on the Oculus Quest 2 virtual reality headset.
That's right, and when we unboxed it for the first time, we decided that I was going to test it out first. Now, this was an absolutely hilarious moment and something we'll never forget. I tossed on the VR headset. I was interacting with the virtual environment for the first time. And we were just laughing hysterically and a moment that'll go down in history, that's for sure.
When it came to my turn, this is when we ran into some hiccups. We realized virtual reality hasn't specifically been designed for people with various physical disabilities. For example,
since I have spastic cerebral palsy, I lack the fine motor skills to hold on to the controllers, press the buttons, or use the thumbsticks.
I also can't stand up and walk around since I'm in the wheelchair. Thankfully, a company called WalkinVR found a solution for both these issues and opened up the virtual door for people with various physical disabilities. I was absolutely ecstatic when we found this software. It enabled me to enter the virtual world in an all-new way, where my arms become the controllers.
WalkinVR has been available since 2017 for research, therapy centers or clinics, where it can be used as additional engaging activity to make regular therapy more varied. It can be applied to people with different conditions like cerebral palsy, spinal cord injury, traumatic brain injury, muscular dystrophies, spinal muscular atrophies, neuropathy, and orthopedic problems. WalkinVR has five key features.
Number 1. Adjusting the position of the controller.
Adjusting the position of the controller can be used for players with limited mobility. Players can compensate for movement restrictions. For example, it helps those who cannot raise their controllers to the height required by the game.
Number 2. Virtual movement and rotation.
Virtual movement and rotation is for players who can't move or turn around easily, like wheelchair users. This feature is useful when the game requires you to kneel, stand, and turn 360 degrees. You can do it with your controllers by grabbing and dragging the space.
Number 3. Gameplay in VR with assistance.
Gameplay in VR with assistance is something you use when a player can't move or rotate but also can't press the buttons. Another person simply uses the Xbox controller to move the player or press the buttons on behalf of him or her. This simple feature also opens up VR to people who can hold the controllers but can't press buttons or thumbsticks.
Number 4. Reclined gameplay.
Reclined gameplay is for players who can't keep vertical position. It simply rotates the view like you would do in real life with a mirror.
Number 5. Hand tracking.
And last but not least is hand tracking. We will use it to track my hands without any controllers. We will use the Kinect, but WalkinVR also supports other devices like Kinect Azure, Intel Real Sensor, or Beck. And note that these features can be used in combination like we will show you shortly. So stay with us.
Now this may seem a little bit overwhelming if you're new to virtual reality, but trust us, it's really not that difficult. Now there definitely is a little bit of a learning curve when it comes to VR, but if you follow the steps that we're about to show you in this video, it should be smooth sailing, and it's definitely worth it in the end. Right, Brad? Now here's a quick look at the WalkinVR website. Now WalkinVR is a software that makes VR accessible for people with physical disabilities. Now we highly recommend you guys check out this website so you can get more information and just see all the cool features that WalkinVR offers. Now WalkinVR was mostly funded by the developer's other project, which is Driver for VR. Now this is a software that provides body tracking, head and hand tracking, controller emulation, and alternative VR configurations. If you support Driver for VR, then you're supporting WalkinVR as well. We're going to be putting links to both these softwares in the description of this video so you guys can go and check them out. All right, now let's get into the setup. We decided to show you guys the full setup from A to Z, just in case you wanted to recreate this setup or you're just curious how WalkinVR works. So here Brad and I are entering the play area. As you guys can tell, Brad's pretty excited to start this VR session. So right now I have Brad positioned towards the back of the room. This is because I'm going to need some space here to do the setup. Now I just quickly wanted to mention that you do need a PC VR setup. In our case, we're using the Oculus Quest 2 headset, but you can use any other headset like the Vive Cosmos, the Valve Index, or other. And we also have a Kinect pointing at Brad. So first thing I'm going to do here is walk over to the computer and start the Oculus software. I'm going to go into settings here, go into beta, and I'm going to activate AirLink. Now this allows for the Oculus Quest 2 headset to connect wirelessly to our desktop computer. Now I have the VR headset on, and I'm going through the settings to connect to the computer. All right, so now that we're all connected to the computer, I'm gonna take off the headset here. I'm gonna go over to the computer, and I'm gonna start the WalkinVR software. Now at the same time as the WalkinVR software starts, it also automatically starts SteamVR. I'm also gonna display VRView. Now this is important because it replicates what's happening inside the VR headset onto the computer monitor. Now this allows me to help Brad navigate the menu options and help guide him in the virtual world. I have the VR controllers in my hand and I'm swinging them around. And as you guys can see on the monitor, it's replicating exactly what I'm seeing in the VR headset. So I'm now gonna navigate over to hand tracking in the WalkinVR settings. And I'm gonna enable use selected tracking device for hand tracking. Now what this is gonna do is it's gonna activate the Kinect, which is then gonna track our entire body. And in this specific case, our hands and arms. Next step here, I'm gonna calibrate the VR headset and the Kinect. So now it's gonna take me through the calibration process. So all you have to do here is just put back on the headset, pick up the VR controllers, stand still, put your hands to the side, forward or backwards and put your hands to the side again. And now you're all calibrated. So as you guys can see here, I have no VR controllers in my hands, but the VR controllers in the virtual world are moving. Essentially, right now, my hands and arms are the virtual controllers. All right, so at this point, my job is done, and it's time for Brad to enter the play area. So I'm gonna put the Oculus Quest 2 headset on Brad's head. And as you guys can see, as Brad moves his arms, the virtual controllers are moving. So what I like to do here is I like to play around with the WalkinVR settings, because in Brad's case, his arms are normally by his sides. So in some games, it's difficult to see the virtual controllers. So right now you're gonna see me go into motion range and boost. And what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna reposition the VR controllers to be more in front of Brad. So even though Brad's hands are more by his side, he'll still be able to see the VR controllers because they'll be positioned in front of him. Now I'm gonna go into more settings here and I'm gonna activate the reclined gameplay feature. Now this is a great setting for Brad because he's often looking upwards. So inside the virtual world, his head level is not really centered. So this setting kind of offsets it and allows for the gameplay to be centered. All right, so now that we got the optimal settings for Brad, let's jump into some Beat Saber. So as you guys can see, Brad's left arm is now the red Beat Saber. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna grab the Xbox controller that's connected to our computer. And this is gonna allow me to make selections for Brad. So as you guys can see, I'm actually using Brad's arm to navigate through different menu options, and I'm looking at the computer monitor to see exactly what Brad's seeing and choose the correct option. Once we get to the correct option, I use the Xbox controller to make the selection by pressing on one of the buttons. Now here's another look at that same process. So right now we just chose the song that Brad's going to be playing, we've already selected some of the settings, and now we're going to jump into the action. Now for the first couple minutes, I often sit behind Brad's wheelchair and help him move his arms just to warm him up and get his arms going. And then once he's all warmed up, it's go time.
I'm so excited about the possibilities of virtual reality. We are in the early stages, and there's still a lot of work that needs to be done. But I'm happy there's companies like WalkinVR paving the way for accessibility in the VR world.
Well said, Brad. That's it, guys. We're just getting started with the VR content, so make sure you stick around and follow our journey. Brad, All Access Life.
Out.